الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله. Important statement here. Important statement from Sheikh Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Sheikh Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, بعض الناس يظن أن النفاق كان في عهد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وانتهى. He said, some of the people, they think that النفاق, it was only at the time of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, and after the death of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, النفاق is done. Some of the people, they think النفاق was only at the time of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. So after him, it is what? It is done. Like who? Who have that belief? Abba Ismail? Like who have that belief? Like those who believe that النفاق, it is only at the time of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم and it is done. يقول واقع؟ لا. أحسنت. Very good. Somebody help him. He got it. All the way from Mississippi. The Murji'a. And who else? The Mu'tazila. The Mu'tazila. Because for them it is only. The Khawarij likewise. For them it is only. Imma the believer, imma the disbeliever. The Mu'tazila Barak, they are not saying he's a Nifa. They will put a between. Not to say that he is a believer nor a disbeliever. Or not to say he's a Munafiq. No, it is a between. In between. And they don't have no name for the in between. Likewise, barakallahu feekum. Those who from the, likewise also the Khawarij, barakallahu feekum. I think the brother mentioned it, right? Likewise, the Khawarij, they only have two groups. Imma the person is a Muslim or believer, or he is a disbeliever, wa al-iyadu billah. So the Shafidahullah tabarakatuh, he said the same way Ibn Taymiyyah, and we'll pray with, inshallah. He said, Ba'dun Nas, some of the people, they say that al-nifaq is only at the time of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wantaha. He say, ghalat. This is a mistake. This is a great mistake. But look at the statement of Hudhayfa. Look at the statement of Hudhayfa radiyallahu anhu. Hudhayfa radiyallahu anhu, he mentioned. He said, al-nifaq, al-yawm, the hypocrisy, and he was talking about at his time, and he was a sahabi. He said, the hypocrisy of today, أشد منه. He say النفاق اليوم أشد منه في عهد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The hypocrisy today. He was talking about his time, right? He say the hypocrisy at that time and his time. He say it was even worse than the nifaq at the time of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فما بال بعهدنا. Then how about our time today? If Hudhayfa is saying that the nifaq at his time was worse than the nifaq of the time of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how about our nifaq? How about barakallah the nifaq of our time? But look at the reason why he say this. He say kana al-munafiquna fi ahdi rasulillahi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because the hypocrites at the time of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he say yukhfawna nifaqihim, they used to do what? To hide their hypocrisy. They used to hide it. They used to hide the hypocrisy. But he say, Amma al-yawm, as in regard to today, people of hypocrisy, he say, قَدْ أَظْهَرُوا نِفَاقَهُمْ. They openly manifest their nifaq. Openly manifest their nifaq, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. So, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, next week we'll be reading the remaining point of this mas'ala or this issue, which is tafsir al-nifaq. And we'll be reading بإذن الله تعالى the statement of Sheikh Ahmed ibn Yahya al-Najmi rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'ah, and likewise the statement of Sheikh Ubaid al-Jabiri hafidhahullah in regard to this point, so we can inshallah ta'ala have more details of al-nifaq, and we will inshallah be reading the likes of the nifaq, what is the word, the root word of al-nifaq, and where is that word coming from, barakallahu feekum, and why is it called al-nifaq. وَصَلِّ اللَّهُمَّ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ. If I say anything that was not correct, please rectify me. And if there is anything that to be rectified, please rectify with evidence. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah in our circle. Amen.
That stops it.